It's been exactly 1 year since we released the 8 episodes on the life of Sadhguru Sri Brahma in October 2019. 8 months have passed since we could travel anywhere. Now a small window has opened up to travel to Uttarakhand. Since we came to know that Sadhguru Sri Brahma has been there, I am traveling alone to the Himalayas now. Many of you called me to appreciate the work and a few expressed it in the comment section. Some of them keep calling me to remind me and push me towards releasing the second series. I understand their enthusiasm. Okay, now we have seen this, what next? I would like to say to them that we did not make the videos to just inform and entertain. Our intention through documenting his life was to make people open up to a dimension of grace and presence that's available even today. The few places that were left were slowly disappearing. I wanted people to start to visit these places, take part in the happenings and support them in whichever way possible. As I travel to many more places across the country to bring you all the information possible, I seek your participation and support in keeping these spaces alive for yourself and future generations.
Namaskaram, Priyanka.
Namaskaram.
Priyanka Dalal, a friend, interviewed me for her blog, and I thought of sharing a few excerpts from that.
For me, I've always been interested in wanting to know about siddhas, yogis. Wherever possible, I would go visit these siddhas, samadhis, and how are they different from us and our lifestyle. So all these things I was always interested in. And this particular one is of interest because of my grandfather's connection with Sadhguru Sri Brahma. So I wanted to know more about him, and over a period of time, it happened over a period of more than 16, 17 years, gradually collecting information, going to these places. And every place I went to, each place had a different story to tell, because these are not coming under a common administrative setup. So each ashram has its own administration, and because it's geographically also apart from each other, each place has their own story of Sadhguru Sri Brahma's life. Once we move into a city, we become oblivious to the whole the ancient yogic tradition and culture, which is so much in abundance in this country. Today in modern world, people are going through all kinds of stress, tension, anxiety, depression, all these things, and they're looking for some kind of solutions. Easiest way is to go and sit in such places, you know, spend some time there with eyes closed, could make a big difference, because the very reverberance of these places, the very vibration of these places could support people to become more peaceful and calm within them, to get rid of their depression or anxieties. This could all support in a big way. Another thing that we noticed was the lands. Vijay Kumar discovered a few lands. I can't name it because I also could get into trouble. In Coimbatore, Singanallur, there is a place registered as Sadhguru Seva Trust. But when he went to that place, there is an apartment instead, standing in that place. So somebody had just taken over and built an apartment, changed the papers into their name. So this could have happened to many more places. I was also afraid that if we don't document these places and if we don't encourage people to keep going to these places also will end up like that. Like tomorrow somebody else may take over after these people who are taking care of now go away, or due to certain financial needs, if they have to subject to such forces, we don't know. So we didn't want that to happen. Tirunelveli town, where the old bus stand was, there used to be annual Guru Puja and Annadhanam happening. So when the national highway was built, widened, and the new bus stand all came up, it went away. So that doesn't exist anymore. They say there were more than 72 ashrams around the 1950s, all around Tamil Nadu. But today, whatever we listed is like around 12. That's all is there. Since the lockdown happened, three ashrams reached out to me. This year, in no place Guru Pujas happened. They just did a small ritual. 2-3 people came together and did it. Because no social gathering were allowed from March onwards till July. And that's the time when most of the Guru Pujas happen. And that is the event which brings in some amount of money with which the whole year runs for the ashram. So I'll be putting the links of individual ashram and their contact numbers. So people can call them up, get the details and then contribute, or they can go visit in person and do whatever necessary help. One of the ashrams, the Ellanahalli Ashram, is even planning to start a Goshala next month. So they have sent out a special appeal for that as well. The granddaughter of Sadhguru Sri Brahma, she reached out, and she's 74 years old now, and she said she can't travel because it's risky with this corona thing to even step out. So she lives like 30 kilometers away from the temple that they have built in Naduvatti. She is not able to go. They have appointed a priest to take care of it. And right now she said even to afford a salary for this priest is getting difficult. In whichever way people can contribute to them, they can get in touch with them. So I just request people, you know, even if you cannot financially support, just keep going. Like on a Saturday, Sunday, go there, sit, spend some time. Especially the Coimbatore one, Araspuram, there are children there. You can sponsor lunch there, or you can just go and teach there. When we went, there were two college girls who would come and spend time teaching English to these boys there, because it's like an orphanage. So the question will come, why should we take care of these samadhis? You know, it's somebody who lived and went. What's the point of doing all this? They have made their whole body, their being, as a reverberance which is equivalent to a temple's vibrance. When they leave their body itself is given samadhi in a certain way. All these dimensions are written down, how accomplished yogi has to be buried, turmeric, vibhuti and few other special ingredients are filled and then covered, and on top of that a shivalingam is kept. The Jiva Samadhi has its own reverberance. Many of the major temples which are having the Shivalinga on top of it, the sanctum sanctorum of many temples are Jiva Samadhis of Siddhars. That's how vibrant they made their body, that they became the sanctum of many temples. So it's not just about maintaining some Jiva Samadhi, it's for many other people to go and make use of it for themselves. In Chennai itself, there are more than 400 samadhis, Jiva samadhis, of yogis, siddhars who had taken samadhi in Chennai alone. Right from the Kabalishwara temple around the vicinity of that to Besanagar, in Egmore. So somebody, if they are interested, they can go to the nearest Jiva samadhi that is there, attend to them, see what needs to be done. Because today the social media is such a fast thing and very easily accessible to everybody. They can just start posting pictures, you know, every Friday or whenever the puja is happening, they can go live and create a community around it. The responsibility that we have to take it up to make sure that at least the basic functioning of these places needs to be funded and supported by the locals. We can't wait for any organization or government to take care of these things.